Hi everyone, in today's tutorial, I am presenting a ladder logic to display characters on the I2C LCD with only one I2C instruction. Up to version 5.4.1.1 of LDmicro has issues displaying characters beyond the 16x2 I2C LCD. To resolve this, download these files from the description below. Extract and paste them into the AVRO folder of the libraries for folder of your LDmicro application folder. These library files have been edited to allow the display of characters on 20x4 I2C LCDs. Having more than one I2C write instructions to display characters on the I2C LCD affects the specified PLC cycle time, which then affects the accuracy of the timers, the encoder, and the URAT operations. Let's start with some steps in programming the I2C LCD from tutorial 14. First, note the address of the PC8574 I/O expander module connected to the LCD. When these pairs of solder pads are standing alone, the device address could either be hexadecimal 27 or hexadecimal 3F. Then, its SCL is connected to pin A5 of the Arduino Nano, SDA to pin A4, VCC to 5 volts, and GND to GND. The Rotary Encoder is also connected to the Nano. S1 goes to D2, S2 goes to D3, the key goes to D4, VCC to 5 volts, and GND to GND. See tutorial 19 for details on the Rotary Encoder. Now, open the folder where you have your LDmicro application saved, and navigate to Libraries for Folder, then AVRO Folder. Right-click on i2clib.c, then click on Edit. Ensure that the LCD I2C address corresponds to hexadecimal 27 or hexadecimal 3F as earlier noted, and save. In LDmicro, let's have an encoder instruction with variable count. Limit the count value between 0 and 100. Split the count value into 3 separate digits of ont, tens, and units, and convert the digits to ASCII format. The variables row and col, representing the rows and columns of the LCD, are initialized to 1 and 0. Turn on the LCD backlight with the I2C write instruction by setting the send variable as hexadecimal 10, the I2C address as hexadecimal 27, and the I2C register as 255. Another I2C write instruction with the same address and register will send all characters with the send variable DISP to the LCD. These characters are sent sequentially to each column of each row of the LCD, thus reducing the required number of I2C instructions. Above these rungs, 2 rungs will sequentially send characters to variable DISP. In the first of the rungs, when the first row of the LCD is selected and col is equal to 0, the LCD is set to display characters starting from row 1, column 1. This is then followed by sending the required characters for each column to variable DISP, in this case, encoder count. Similarly, in the next row, when the second row of the LCD is selected and col is 0, the LCD is set to display characters starting from row 2, column 1. The variables ont, tens, and units are displayed on row 2, columns 1, 2, and 3. Now, select the microcontroller type of Atmel AVRO 80Mega328. Assess the MCU parameters option from the settings menu to display the PLC configuration dialog. Ensure that the PLC cycle time is 10 milliseconds, as any value too high or too low affects other functions. Set the MCU crystal frequency to 60 MHz for Arduino Nano and change the I2C rate to 400,000x for fast mode. In the variable window, assign the encoder variables of XQA0, XQB0, XQZ0, and YQDIR0 to pins 2 to 5 of the Arduino Nano. Also assign I2C SEL and SDA to pins A5 and A4 of the Nano. From the compile menu, compile atmel-avro-gcc, build C solution, and call flash MCU. See tutorial 12 to configure this mode. We can now see the encoder count on the LCD. Next, connect the middle pin 2 of the LM35 temperature sensor to A0 of the Arduino Nano, pin 1 to VCC, and pin 3 to GND. The incubator temperature regulator program from tutorial 19 is modified to work with the I2C LCD. So we have the encoder instruction here, the reading of the analog value here, and the scaling of the temperature sensor reading here. The display variables row and col are initialized to 1 and 0. A 2-second turn-on delay timer prevents the unintended navigation of the menu. When CMenu is equal to 0, the calculated temperature value is separated into the three respective digits and scaled as in the last example. Rung 15 displays temperature on the first row of the LCD, while rung 17 displays the temperature value and its unit of measurement on the second row. When CMenu is equal to 1, the set point L value is sent to the encoder count variable, adjusted to the required value, separated into the three digits, and converted to ASCII format. Room 21 then displays low set point on the first row of the LCD, while row 23 displays the adjusted set point value and DIC-C on the second row. When CMenu is equal to 2, rungs 25, 27, and 29 performs similar operations of the low set point for the I set point. Then we have the I2C LCD write instructions. We make persistent instructions to store the set point and the heater control logic. Assign the temperature sensor to A0 of the Nano. Compile and upload the program to the Arduino Nano. Press the encoder knob for about 2 seconds to access the low set point menu. Rotate the knob to adjust the set point. Press the knob to save the set point and proceed to the high set point. Press the knob again after the high set point adjustment to save and exit to the main menu. Next, add a DS3231 RTC module to the circuit connection as shown. The real-time clock program from tutorial 14 is also modified. Rung 2 initializes the variables row, col, and reg. Rung 4 is the encoder instruction. And rung 6 assesses the menu option as in the previous example. In rung 8, when CMenu is equal to 1, the time and date values are retrieved from the ROTC module as in tutorial 14, converted from binary coded decimal format to binary, separated into tens and units, and converted to ASCII format. Variable reg ensures that the second, minute, hour, date, month, and year values are retrieved each per PLC cycle time. In rungs 10, 12, 14, 16, and 18, when CMenu is 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 respectively, The respective variables of hour, minute, date, month, and year can be set to the actual date and time. Rungs 20 and 22 send the required value to variable DISP. Notice that these two rungs are optimized to display the six menu options by making the required adjustment to the segment of the screen. This is achieved with these conditional instructions. Thus, the greater than symbol is displayed on the code 7, 10, and 13 when C menu is equal to 4, 5, and 6 of rung 22. Rungs 24 and 26 are the same as the previous example. When the program is compiled and uploaded into the Arduino Nano, the date and time can be seen on the LCD. Pressing the encoder knob for 2 seconds gives access to the settings menu, where the date and time can be set correctly. Finally, let's add the temperature regulator program to the ROTC program. C menu maximum value is increased to 8. When C menu is equal to 1, the encoder count variable is used to change between displaying the temperature value and displaying the date and time. Thus, when variable count is equal to 0, the temperature will be displayed. And when it is equal to 1, the date and time will be displayed. As before, the settings menu can be accessed after 2 seconds. When scene menu is equal to 2, the low set point setting is displayed. When scene menu is equal to 3, the high set point setting is displayed. When scene menu is equal to 4, 5, up to 8, the respective time and date settings are displayed. This can be seen when the program is compiled and uploaded to the Nano. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. Consider subscribing if you have not. See you in the next one.